What's up, MK Squad? Welcome back to another legendary Top of the Mook reaction video. If you're new to the channel, come and join the MK Squad family and turn your post notifications on and hit that subscribe button. Yay! And if you're already a part of the family, man, we truly appreciate you and thank you, because every single one of you is a blessing, you know. And give this video a big thumbs up, man, if you're an Easy Meal fan. Yeah, I said it. We getting into the Easy Meal today. You know what I mean? And it helps out the channel a lot. It's totally free and it helps crush that YouTube algorithm. So just hit that thumbs up. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, comment down below any videos y'all want us to react to, because we sure will be reacting to them. So today we got Easy Meal Kaleem music video. I think I'm saying it right. If I botched the name, sorry. I didn't mean to. You know what I'm saying? And I tried my best here. You know what I'm saying? Give me my props. You know what I'm saying? So I ain't gonna do no more talking. Let's get into this video, man. You can tell, like, this is probably when he was first coming up. Like, you know what I mean? I might be wrong. I'm just saying, it seemed like that.
What's up, but you're not answering. I wish you could just open up to me so we could just talk about stuff. And yes, I wrote a song because I ran out of ideas to get you to notice me. I'm trying to tell you something. Talk to me. Like, what the fuck is happening? Just tell me.
I could relate to this. Just like a random heartbreak where you're just confused and just... It's like, from my experience, I had this happen to me. I'm gonna be real. I had a female, you know. I'm thinking everything good or whatever, you know. Have conversation. I'm the type of guy, I like to have conversation about goals. Where we try and go, what we try and do. How can we support each other? What you like to do, what I like to do, what I'm trying to pursue, what you trying to pursue. You know what I mean? And you know, my head is tunnel vision. I'm trying to get there. I think about, like, you know, sacrificing my early ages, my 20s, so I could live it up, you know, for my older self. You know what I'm saying? So when you invest and save your money as you're young, like I'm 21. When you invest your money and you save your money when you young, it'll pay your older self. You know what I'm saying? But if you don't have no money invested or saved, God forbid a rainy day come along, what do you, like, how are you going to save yourself? That's why I feel like I use this analogy. Save money so money could save you. You see what I'm saying? It's four L's. Liquidity, longevity, and legacy. No, it's three L's, sorry. Liquidity, longevity, and legacy. So liquidity is when you're making the money, right? You're getting the money in, you know what I'm saying? But what are you doing with the money to make longevity-wise, make it long-term, a long-term investment? Saving, you know what I'm saying? A lot of people do stocks and bonds, you know. Invest in life insurance, index fund, you know what I mean? All those type of core things, you know what I'm saying? Properties, real estate, you know, you get your return back on things, you know what I'm saying? That being... assets, not liabilities, you know, all those type of investopedia terms, you know what I mean? And then the legacy is what you could leave behind. I could leave behind to my son, you know what I mean? So I believe in working hard, you know what I'm saying? But I thought, back to the story, I thought everything was good, you know. I'm talking about, yeah, we good, we gonna get an apartment, we gonna grow, we gonna invest, we gonna save, you know what I'm saying? We gonna do this together. Because I feel like it's even in the Bible, you can read it yourself. Two is always better than one. If the higher power said it, rest be assured that's what it is. You know what I mean? But the simple fact is, it's true. And it's not you looking to fall, you put your stuff onto someone else. You know what I mean? It's the simple fact that when you have a partner and y'all in it together, if something falls on you, you got to deal with that alone. But then if something falls on you or your partner, y'all can help each other. And y'all come back stronger. You see what I'm saying? And togetherness is always stronger than, you know, being by yourself or handling it by yourself. But it goes back to, like, say when you want something, you have something internalized, you want to go to somebody you can trust to vent to and talk to. A lot of people had this mentality, oh, I don't want to put your problems on you. You know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, if you're a person like myself, I just say I want to pursue goals, I'm tunnel vision, you know, I'm talking about liquidity, I'm talking about longevity, I'm talking about leaving a legacy. Well, if I pass any day by now, because tomorrow isn't promised, who can I give those passwords, my business, my platform to, that I could carry on so the legacy can be alive? So you got to have somebody to talk to. It's not that you're putting your problems on them. It's a simple fact that we all subconsciously vent. And sometimes we do it indirectly, but we're still venting and we want to be heard. Just a simple fact of being heard and, you know, you and that whoever you trust and love that you can vent to, and y'all laugh it off and make that something negative or something that's disturbing positive to make a stronger self, to build each other up. That's what it's about. But I feel like that's what this song is about. Because, you know what I'm saying, relating to that experience, you know, because I just told you what type of person I am and what I was talking about with the girl that, you know, ex-girl that I did it from my experience. And then all of a sudden, out of nowhere, she just said, Keon, I'm done. Heartbroken, shattered, you know, I'm having goals, I'm thinking we down, we into this together, you know, was good to her, respected her, loved her, you know, treated her the way I want to be treated, you know, the whole nine, you know, helped her when she needed help financially, you know, well, as much as I can, you know, I did the whole shebang, and then out of nowhere, just stop talking to me, said I'm done, didn't respond to me no more, didn't answer none of that. As much as I try to seek explanation and try to mend things and, you know, get back on track on the same page, or at least hear her out, even though I was already heartbroken on top of it, you know what I'm saying? But things happen, you know what I'm saying? I just look at it like the good days bring happiness, the bad days bring experience, the worst days bring breakthroughs. And that's what I feel like this song going through, so I could relate to it. And I can imagine any other people that could relate to it and it touched their hearts in a different way. It don't have to be, you know, someone leaving you, you know, in relationships. And it could be you just being heartbroken for something that you wanted to do and you trying to seek explanation from, you know, if you were an athlete and you trying to seek explanation why you cut from the team. It could be anything, you know what I mean? But that was my experience, and that's how I'm relating to this song, and I bring my story to you guys. You know what I'm saying? But comment down below how you guys can relate to this song.
Something I'm begging you. I dropped my biggest cover and I wanted you to be there to see it through. Your support is what I look forward to the most. But you're choosing to post a selfie to your feet instead of answering me. Do you,
I had that happen.
Do you feel like everybody's drowning you? The silent treatment you're giving people is fucking immature. You should act rage and tell me if you are depressed. Tell me each.
See, another thing I learned, this is the message I'm getting from this song. Isolation. I understand some people, you know, you go through depression, you know, and it takes the heart, it's hard to get through a mental mentally suffering state. Or a suffering mentality state where you're depressed, upset, really sad. You know, you're confused, you don't know why you feel this way. But just know, it's okay not to be in the know. That's the problem with us. We have to be able to embrace the uncomfort and be at peace with it to know later on we will understand why that happened. But if we keep trying to figure it out, we're destroying ourselves instead of going through the motion. You know what I mean? And the simple fact is you can isolate yourself. You know, sometimes some people that's depressed or whatever might don't want to be around people, don't want to, you know, talk right now, you know, just want to be to themselves. But I would consider isolating, it's a proper way to isolate yourself. You know, let your loved ones, let them know, like, look, I'm going through this and I want some space. You know what I'm saying? Don't just isolate and don't give nobody no explanation on, because then you're destroying yourself and also destroying that relationship with your loved one. Because like in this song, Easy Miller don't even know what's going on. He's trying to contact her. She over here posting on social media, acting regular, daggler, throwing on a facade for social media, you know, flexing. You know how Instagram and, you know, Twitter and all that be. But for real, they be broke. Let's be real here. And they be on vacation all the way down Miami or something. You know, the flight's cheap right now. You know what I'm saying? Got the stimulus check. You up out of there. You see what I'm saying? You get down there. You come back. You got $20 in your name. You feel what I'm saying? Priority fucked up. But that's how I be, man. But you know, it's the same thing that's going on here. You know what I'm saying? But I feel like people, I'm going to just leave it here. And I'm going to stop rambling. I'm going to watch the rest of the the video with you guys. I feel like people that love with their eyes rather than their heart never loved you. Because if this female right here flexing on the gram, taking pictures, not responding to him, she probably loved the man just because what she seen physically or something she liked that he did. But she never really loved him with his heart, because people that love with their heart is in togetherness. They're in unity. They're inseparable. They get through it. Now, see, a lot of people want something but don't want to do the work to get it. It don't work that way. It don't work that way. You got to invest. Everything you invest your time in, and if you're doing it positively, it will reciprocate. Just like karma, whatever you put out, you'll get back in return. Whatever energy you put out, you'll get back in return. Don't be looking. The problem with this as well is we want to be looking around like, what's wrong with him? What's wrong with her? Well, you ever think that you could be the problem? Look yourself in the mirror. You ever think that you could be the problem? I did it a couple times. I had to figure out the whole time. I'm thinking something wrong with somebody else. I'm the problem. Whoa, we get shocked when we realize, oh, we the problem. Don't be shocked. You can be the problem sometimes. That's okay. But are you going to put in the work to fix the problem? Now, I'm going to just leave it there. I'm going to leave them diamonds with you guys. You see what I'm saying, family? I just wanted to spit some knowledge. I already know I'm rambling a lot, but I hope you guys enjoyed the rambling and fully embraced it, you know. And I appreciate you if you watched it this far in the video. You know what I'm saying? But let's go, let's go. We're just gonna finish it off.
This is every problem. Get it off your fucking chest. You put me in a position in your life that I deserve to know. Yes, I'm willing to pull all this effort for you, you fucking hoe. Tell me if it's someone else so my dad can say I told you so. I saw my whole future with you, but you're forcing me to let you go.
It's crazy because I wrote letters and did all that. Like, I can relate to this. A lot of people say you're a fool for love. You could be a fool for love. I don't think you're a fool. I just think you're following your heart. You know what I'm saying? And when you know the no, and you know the why you're doing something, how can you be a fool? This is something you're passionate about. You know what I'm saying? I feel like a fool is something that just unconfused, don't stand for nothing, don't know what they doing, just doing it just to do it, don't even know the why and why they doing it.
Colleen, I hope you know that I'm really fucking serious. I don't know if there's something that I did back in the past where you were in the Shining show and I was worried to shit because of the stories that you told me of the frontman Nicholas. Until it came to a point you were telling me you were gonna leave the venue. Then you started sending fucked up messages of you typing help. Lost my shit, I got Joseph to call Detroit police to attend you. Your reply stopped and you don't know how that felt. It all passed, you replied and you told me that you were fine. All sorts of comfort and relief came to my fucking mind. I told you this experience of fear was my first time. But it's like you're disregarding the fact that I was traumatized. Now I'm questioning my fucking self if you still care about me like I care for you. Let me guess, you fucking don't. Cause if you did, you'd be giving minutes and hours to talk to me out of your fucking day, you fucking bitch. What's a relationship without communication? A motherfucking dead one. You should be living up to insane that you told me that whenever you love someone, you give her your all. You made my feelings with this much for you. That's why I'm willing to make this song. You not talking to me makes me feel like everything I do for us is fucking wrong. How fucking dare you drag me into your life and make me feel special? If you're the one who's letting us shatter and fucking fall.
Oh man, that dude, it make you go crazy, man. I feel this song. This song did me chill.
Colleen, I just want to understand everything that you feel, but you just ain't giving.
And the more he's sending audios and stuff, the more and more it's eating at him. Like, the more and more it's bothering him mentally. And it's not like when you're in a situation like this, your mind is like a engine. It's not, you know what I'm saying? The soul know what it want, but sometimes you got to learn how to calm your mind. And right now, the more he texting, the more he feeding his mind like she's going to answer. And when she's getting no reply, he's getting hurt and more hurt and more hurt.
give me anything to hold on to. Your actions seem like you're choosing to ignore me, and why is that? Please just let me understand. Don't make me blame it on you. Is it these judgmental fucks who keep contacting you about shining? Or the depressive feeling you're getting from grieving from your friends who passed away? Who is making you feel that bad? And smother that you're left with literally zero things to say. It's making me think that maybe the full cancer of your dad got the good of him. This is what my overthinking mind does when it knows my heart hasn't had a speck of fucking attention from the essence of a person it's attached to. I apologize with all my soul for anything I may have done to make you feel it's necessary to go non-existent. I'm genuine and blunt to you, so please be the same. Cause to me this ain't a fucking game. I dig absolutely everything about you to my fucking heart, and that's my imperfection. Are you still willing to stick to me? Cause your motherfucking inconsistent just shows just you don't love me enough. You ain't even missing me. Cause unlike you, Colleen, you're the person I wanna be talking to every single day. It's give and take. Where is the equality? So please, before I leave my country, if you are giving us up, just tell me you don't love me so the pain dies peacefully and you set me free.
Dang. Dang. Well, it's just that type of thing. What's meant is went. What the internet has made it increasingly easy to connect with others and share lives, which can be a good thing. The internet has also made it increasingly easy for anyone to believe that the online relationships feel like real love. Now, that's facts. You see what I'm saying? Because, you know, you post a picture and, you know, you post your girl and, you know, you thinking like, oh, yeah, I really love her. Like, she's the one. She's amazing. She, you know what I'm saying? You know, I just feel like people be using it for bragging rights. But is there real love within? And behind the scenes, no one knows that besides those two individuals. You know what I'm saying? Like, I post my girl, my family here and there, but I just feel like, for what, you know what I'm saying? Like, I wouldn't put too much out there, because the simple fact is, behind the scenes, I just feel like, behind the scenes, you gotta put in the work, you know what I'm saying? I just feel as though you should be humble about it. And I'm not saying that you're not being, just because you post your family, and you know, you wanna spread and inspire, that's not, you know, being humble. I'm just saying that's how I look at it. That's my lens, from my lens. I try not to do it, you know, most of the time, because I feel like it could be a distraction sometimes. You know, you constantly posting and you feel like you gotta feed the media pictures, and then people come to you like, oh my goodness, like, look at you, I love you guys' pictures on Instagram, keep posting them, I love them, you know what I'm saying? Then you gotta, your mind just keep telling you, I gotta have another picture. I gotta have another thing. What's the next thing? What's the next picture? What's it? You know what I'm saying? Well, in reality, you should only be feeding your mind with positivity and feeding how you can grow and evolve with the ones you love. You see what I'm saying? And then you could post your little pictures here and there. You know what I'm saying? To inspire. You know what I'm saying? And that's about it. You know? But this statement right here is facts. Because some people might seem like, oh, relationship good, but we don't really know what's going on behind that picture. We don't know. You see what I'm saying? I like to post pictures when I'm in a good place with my family, you know, with the love of my life, and you know, we're in a good place. But I don't like to be on social media too much because it distracts from what needs to be done. And I had this inspirational line. Because I've been reading this book called Rich Dad, Poor Dad. It was an inspirational line that I loved. I realized, and this might get a little bit off the topic, but I'll twist it back up where it gets back to what I'm saying. Lamborghini never has car commercials, because Lamborghini consumers never have time to sit around and watch TV. So it's the same way with me. I don't have time to be posting pictures and all this stuff about my family. I take pictures and secure for myself for memories. You know, you want to have memories, loving memories to look back on and, you know, cherish and embrace and like, wow, like that was a good day. You know what I'm saying? Because your bad days, that's the significance of pictures being put up on your wall, you know, of loved ones and stuff. Like, when you're going through a bad day, you can just look back and like, wow. You know, it can take your mind off of the negativity to be more grateful, embrace whatever you're going through, and be calm at peace. Like, there's going to be better days, you know what I'm saying? But I feel as though I don't have time to be sitting on social media to be constantly posting pictures to feed an environment that's They're not going to put in the work for me. You know what I'm saying? And they're distracting me from the purpose I'm trying to do to provide and uplift and, you know, being the man of my family. You know what I mean? That's just how I look at it. I don't got time to be sitting around on social media every day. I'd rather read a book or invest in myself and learn something else where I could grow to, you know, apply it to teach my family, to teach the love of my life, to teach myself how to be a better version of myself, a better partner, a better father. You see what I'm saying? I always want to learn. I love learning. I love improving. And I love vernacular words. You know what I'm saying? I love the priority of learning new words so I can speak elegantly, I guess. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video, man. I know I did a lot of rambling, but I hope you guys took something from it. Hope you guys are having an amazing, blessed day. Stay peace. Stay spreading that peace, love, and positivity, baby, and stay strong. Love you guys, and I'm going to leave out with the legendary peace.